guys, welcome back. So in today's video, I'm going to share this gorgeous, stunning bridal makeup look with you, which is definitely going to work on all Indian brides out there. It's a very wearable yet very dramatic look, which you can wear with most of your bridal outfits. I'm going to show you each and every step of doing this look, but before going to that, make sure you subscribe and let's get started. So before putting any sort of makeup, you just need to well cleanse your face using a good cleanser. Now it's time to moisturize your skin. Today I am using this Pack Moisture Lotion, which is one of my favorite products, guys. It's so hydrating on the skin. It works so well underneath your makeup. And I think for the brides, this is a must buy product. So I'm just applying it religiously on all over my face and using my fingertips to just blend it in my face. And you can see I'm just taking my time to just massage it well in my face. And you have to moisturize your skin, guys, because you want your skin to look really plumped and hydrated. So a moisturizer is a must when you are creating any sort of makeup look. I have also applied moisturizer on my neck as well, so that my neck looks also hydrated and moisturized. Another step which I'm doing today is that I am applying a little bit of eye cream. This one is also by Pack, and also putting it underneath my eyes and also applying it on my eyelids to just make my eyes look really radiant and bright. So if your eyes are not that well moisturized, it will be looking dull and not that good in pictures. So make sure that your eyelids, your under eyes are well moisturized and well hydrated, and that will definitely show up on your skin when you just put a lot of layers of makeup on your skin. So also going to prep my lips. I have already prepped my lips. I am using this Laneige lip slipping mask, which is my staple lip product. And to add a little bit of tint on my lips, I'm using Maybelline Baby Lips in the shade Highline Wine. And you can see I just will allow the moisturizer to just seep deep into my pores and into my skin. And in the meantime, I'm going to do my eyebrows, for which I'm taking a spoolie and just brushing it through my brows to know the natural shape of my brow. For the brow product today, I'm using Pack Super Brow Eyebrow Cream in the shade Cedar Cream, and I'm using this particular brush for applying this product. This is a Pack 099 brush, which comes with the eyebrow brush on one side and a spoolie on the other side, which you can definitely use. So as you can see, following the natural shape of my brow, at first I'm just outlining my brow using this product, and using small strokes I am going to fill in the gaps of my brows with the help of the same product. Also going to create small hair like strokes in the front part of my brow so that it looks natural. And this is a cream based eyebrow product, guys, but when it sets, it becomes completely smudge proof, botch proof, perfect for brides out there. If you want your eyebrow product to last on your brows for a very long time, this is a product which you can definitely try out. I'm using a spoolie to just evenly distribute the product in my brows, as you can see, and this particular shade goes really well on most Indian skin tones, guys. Now I'm taking a little bit of concealer, and with the help of a flat shader brush, I am just cleaning out the edges of my brows so that my brows look really prominent and nice. It looks amazing in pictures, guys. So you can use this hack, but make sure that you blend out the concealer really well so that it looks really natural. And if you have any sort of baby hairs, eyebrow hairs, this step will actually help you in just hide those baby hairs. So again, I'm using a spoolie and just brushing it through my brows to add oomph, and that will help you making your brows look really lifted and prominent. And I really like the effect, guys. This is how I generally do my eyebrows, guys, and I really like how it actually looks on me. Now it's time to prime my face. So whenever you will be creating any sort of heavy makeup, make sure that you prime your face, because a primer actually helps in sticking your foundation really well on your face. It also helps in just creating a nice barrier between your skin and your foundation so that your foundation doesn't seep deep into your pores and clog your pores. Today I'm using this Pack Oil Control Primer, and I love this primer, guys. I got it a few days back and I really, really like it. It's such a nice smoothening primer, perfect for oily to combination skin. Even for a normal skin, you can use this product. It also adds a lot of hydration to the skin as well, which I really, really like. It's so smooth. It has got gold flecks in it, which also adds a little bit of glow to your skin. So the next thing which you can do is that you can use a strobing cream or a strobe cream on your face. Today I'm using this one by MAC in the shade Pink Light. So a strobe cream helps in adding a lot of glow to your skin. It also adds a lot of dewiness and glow to your foundation as well. So it's basically a nourishing cream which has got lots of glow in it, and this helps in making your skin look really illuminating, really radiant and nice. You can use any strobing cream you have in your collection, but this one is my favorite. You can also even mix a little bit of strobe cream with your foundation to add a lot of glow to your face. And you can see I've mostly applied it on all over my face. And the next step which I'll be doing is that I'm going to color correct my face. So color correction is a process by which you actually hide your pigmentation imperfections that you have on your face. You can use an orange color corrector to just color correct your face, but today I'm using a darker shade of concealer, a very darker shade of concealer to just color correct my face. I'm putting it on the areas where I have got a little bit of darkness going on my acne scars, on my hyperpigmentation, and I'm just using this pack concealer brush to just blend this out. And you can see it helps in just making my face look really even out and hide those imperfections. But make sure that you set your color correction with the help of a translucent powder or any setting powder you have, because if you don't set your color correction, it will be mixing with your foundation and will be looking really dull and off, which will be not looking flattering at all. So you can see the step has added such a nice even look to my face. For the foundation today, I'm using my all-time favorite Too Faced Born This Way foundation, and I'm going to at first take one pump of the shade Warm Beige and mix a half a pump of the shade Praline with it and mix it really well to create my own custom shade. And this combination actually works really well on my skin, guys. If you want a good foundation, a luxury foundation which will be looking absolutely stunning on your big day, this is a foundation which you can definitely try out. I love this foundation because of the finish, because of how it actually looks on my skin. Using a damp sponge, I am blending this out, and you can see this is a more or less like a medium coverage foundation. You can definitely build this up, but it looks so nice on the skin. It gives your skin such a nice glowy natural finish which doesn't look cakey. And if you're a bride, this kind of finish is a must, guys. You just don't need a mask of foundation on your face. You just need a good, healthy looking foundation on your face. For the concealer today, I am using Too Faced Born This Way concealer in the shade Warm Beige. And it's a full coverage concealer, guys. It's very thick, so a little goes a long way with this product. So I am just putting it under my eyes, on the bridge of my nose. Also have applied it on my eyelids to just prime my eyelids, because I'm going to create nice and dramatic eye look. Also just blending this in using the same sponge, and you can see this has added such a nice radiant brightness under my eyes. Now to set my concealer and my foundation, I'm using Fit Me loose setting powder in the shade Mini Light Medium, and I'm using the damp sponge to apply that powder just underneath my eyes, on the areas where I have basically have used that concealer. So using a damp sponge with your loose powder helps in making your powder just seep deep into your foundation and helps in setting your foundation really, really well. In this way, you can make your foundation last on your face for a very, very long time. Now using a powder brush to just roughly set my overall face with the help of the same loose setting powder. I have also set my neck, guys, because when you are bride, you just want your makeup to look really good and match with your neck color as well. Now it's time to move on to the eyes. I'm using Huda Beauty Rose Gold Remastered Eyeshadow Palette. I love this eyeshadow palette because of the shade selection and everything. At first, I'm taking this light beige shade, and with the help of a fluffy blending brush, I'm going to apply it on all over my crease, and also going to deepen the outer corner of my eyes also with the help of the same particular shade. I'm taking my time and slowly depositing the color. You can use any neutral nude eyeshadow palette you have in your collection. Now I'm taking this deep brown shade from the palette. With the help of a tapered blending brush, I'm going to apply it basically in the outer V of my eyes and drag it towards my crease to blend it with my transition color. This helps in creating a nice gradient on my eyes. As you can see, you have to blend everything really well, guys. Any kind of eye look you want to create, just blend the eyeshadows really well, and it will be looking absolutely stunning on you. Now I'm taking this gorgeous deep burgundy shade having berry undertones, which is called Manita, and this is very, very pigmented, guys. So I'm just taking a little bit of eyeshadow at first and slowly just depositing the color and slowly applying it on all over my lid as my lid color. This is just acting as a base for my other eyeshadows to work on, and you can see it is so pigmented, so smooth, and there is no fallouts at all, guys. Now taking that dark brown shade again, I'm going to blend out the outer corner again to just make everything look really diffuse and nice. Taking that rusty orange shade from the palette with the help of the fluffy blending brush, I'm going to blend out my edges so that it looks very nice and there is no harsh lines. Now I'm taking this rose gold champagne kind of shimmery shade from the palette, and with the help of my fingers, I'm going to deposit it at the center of my eyelid like this. So the shimmery shades of this Huda palette work the best when you apply it with your fingers. Now I'm taking this typical warm rose gold shade, which is a deeper version of the previous shade which I have applied. I'm going to apply it just around the edges like this to just diffuse that stunning champagne shade which I have put on my lid. Basically, I'm just using it to just diffuse the edges so that everything looks nice and well blended. Also intensifying that champagne shade again at the center of my eyelid. For the glitter today, I'm using this Glitter Mafia press glitter in the shade rose gold, and it's a press glitter, so you just don't need separate glitter glue for applying this particular shade. I'm just applying it at the center of my eyelid, and you can see this is how it turned out. For the kajal today, I'm using Sugar heavy duty coal in the shade Back to Black. It's jet black, it's very pigmented, very creamy, smooth to apply, and when it sets, it's not going to budge. I'm just tightlining my upper waterline with it and also applying it thickly on my lower waterline, as you can see, because I want a lot of drama going on my eyes, because I'm going to now smudge that coal with the help of this brown shade, and with the help of this pencil brush, I'm going to smudge that out, and you can see also just flicking it out in the outer corner of my eyes to create a kind of reverse wing, which I'm going to later merge with the winged eyeliner which I'm going to create. Now I'm taking that Manita shade again and apply it below the previous shade which I have applied on my lower lash line like this. Now to blend out that Manita shade, I'm going to use this rusty orange shade with the help of a very petite crease brush. I'm going to blend out the edges so that it looks nice and it looks more dramatic and stunning. Taking that champagne rose gold shade, I'm going to apply it in the inner one third of my lower lash line, followed by that stunning glitter. I'm going to take in a definer kind of smudging brush and apply it just at the center of my lower lash line, basically in order to match with my upper eyelid. It looks stunning, right? I really like, guys, how it turned out. For the liner today, I'm using my all-time favorite Inglot gel eyeliner in the shade number 77. It's jet black, it's waterproof, it's smudge proof, it's completely matte. Using this liner brush, I'm going to roughly apply it very close to my lashes on my eyelid like this. Taking a smudging brush, I have started on smudging this out. As you can see, it's very, very pigmented and a little goes a long way with this product. So you have to take your time to smudge that out, and also just flicking it out in the outer corner like this to create a kind of fake wing over there. And taking that black eyeshadow from the Huda palette, I'm going to set that liner to make it look really, really intense. If you want to intensify that liner, you can reapply it and it will be looking even more dramatic and nice. And I'm also reapplying that liner very close to my lashes, as you can see, and also just creating a very nice long wing, and just extending it towards the end of my brows. And sorry for not being that in focus, and you can see this is how my final eye look turned out. It's very dramatic yet a very classy, good looking, which will be definitely looking amazing on all skin tones out there. So now it's time to coat my lashes. I'm using my all-time favorite L'Oreal Lash Paradise mascara, coating my upper and my lower lashes with it. It's so volumizing on my lashes, helps in lengthening my lashes as well. I think it's also a must buy product for the brides out there. Also going to apply a pair of falsies, and today I have used the Bay Beauty eyelashes, which I'm going to link in the description box, and you can see this is how my final eye makeup turned out. I really like how it's looking on me. You can definitely try this one out. For the face, I have to complete the rest of my face, and I'm using this contouring duo by Colabar, which is hell pigmented, guys. So make sure that you take a little amount of this and apply it under your cheekbones, on your jawline. This is a very pigmented product, but it looks really good when you just take a lot of photographs. It photographs really, really well, looks amazing in pictures. And also I am contouring my nose. As you can see, I'm just following the natural line, the natural shape of my nose, and extending it and connecting it with my brow bone, and you can instantly see the difference. So make sure that you contour your nose for any kind of occasions, guys. For adding a little bit of bronziness to my face, because when you use a bronzer, you just look really good in pictures. So I'm using the same contour brush and using this Physicians Formula Murumuru Bronzer and just blending it really well on the outer perimeters of my face, on the areas basically where I have contoured my face. But I'm just applying it on a larger area so that it looks much more warm, much more bronzy, and it looks really nice in pictures, guys. Now to sharpen out my contour, I'm using the damp sponge and I'm taking a little bit of loose powder and just sharpening it really, really well so that my face look really structured and defined. And you can see this is how I basically contoured my face when I'm attending any occasions or parties. Now for the blush today, I'm using L'Oreal La Barre A blush in the shade Be Fierce, number 11. It's such a pretty earthy toned blush, guys, which has got a lot of warm undertones. It looks really gorgeous with the kind of eye look which I have created today and with the lips which I'll be just creating today. So I'm just, it's very, very pigmented. So make sure that you just tap off the excess or just remove the excess at the back of your hand and then blend it really well with your contour shade. Make sure that you take your blush from the apples of your cheeks towards your ears so that it looks really nice and well blended. So now I'm taking this makeup fixation makeup setting spray by Pack, and I'm going to just spray it on all over my face to just set my makeup and allow it to dry on my face. And when my face is a little bit damp, I'm going to apply my highlighter. And today I'm using this Rumier Cosmetics Beach Vibes palette, which contains 4 shades of highlighter, and I'm going to mix these 3 shades from the palette and apply it on the highest points of my face. So whenever you're using any kind of highlighter on your damp face, it just appears so stark, so beaming, so blinding on your face. And for the brides, I think this is a hack which you can definitely try out. It just creates a lot of difference, guys. I'm applying it on my cheekbones, on my forehead, on my nose, and blending it really, really well. You can see, you just want your makeup to look really glowy. You just want your face to look really illuminating and glowy. And you can definitely highlight your face in this way and you will be looking absolutely stunning. I'm also applying the highlighter in the inner corner of my eyes to just highlight my eyes. Also going to highlight my brow bone with the help of the same product. Make sure that you blend out really well. It needs to be looking really nice and well blended on your skin, so it will be photographing really, really well. So you can see this is how my highlighted face looks like. Now it's time to remove the excess lip balm with the help of a wet wipe. And for the lipstick today, I'm using Milani Amore Matte Lip Cream in the shade Loved, one of my favorite nude lipsticks of all time. It's in between deep coralish shades and nude shades, guys. It's a deep peachy nude shade having lots of browns in it, having warm undertone, and it's going to look amazing on all skin tones out there. It's a very, very long lasting, not that drying on the lips. It looks stunning with most of my outfits, and I hope that it will be working for you as well. You can wear this lip color with any of your eye looks and you're going to look absolutely, absolutely stunning. It also appears so gorgeous in photographs as well. I really love this lip color. So setting my face one more time to reduce all the powderiness, to just make my makeup last for a very, very long time. And now adding a pink bindi, because my outfit is having a lot of pink and lots of deep peach in it. So for the perfume, you can definitely try out Ajmal Sonora. It's affordable, yet it's having such nice smell, guys. You will smell absolutely stunning if you just wear this perfume, and I really, really like how it turned out. Thank you. this is my take on this year's bridal makeup look, and I really like how it turned out. I hope also you really like it. Make sure you hit on the like button and subscribe to my channel. Going to put the links of the jewelries that I'm wearing and also my outfit in the description box, and also the products which I have used. Please do subscribe. We'll see you soon in my next video. I love you. Bye guys.